Hi and welcome back to our channel. I am so happy to be back with a new video for you. First of all, thank you for watching our videos and thank you for joining our channel. Today I would like to talk to you something about the geometry check on the FMD ECDIS. Everyone know that we get gray hair every time we do a route planning, and suddenly we have an alert called impossible turn or bad leg or bad turn. So I like to show you a little bit about how you can maybe get rid of these alerts by working with the route plan. So let's go to the ECDIS and I will show you how. Now we are here at the ECDIS and we are going to talk about these alerts: impossible turn, bad leg and bad turn. They are all a part of the geometry check on your ECDIS when you do the route planning. So you can see now on my route plan that I have a impossible turn at waypoint 17. Okay, what can you do about the alert of impossible turn? So let's go here in the route plan to waypoint 17. You can see here it highlights in yellow where you can do something about the problem. You can either move this waypoint a little bit or you can decrease the radius. Okay, let's try by decreasing the radius and see if we have, oh, it moved a little bit here. Okay, see, oh, now you can see when the problem starts to get solved, then you will get your XTD limits back. See, I decreased to 0.35 and my alert disappeared. And suddenly one of the other alerts appeared: bad leg, waypoint 6 to waypoint 7. Okay, let's go to in the plan here to waypoint 6 and 7. See, it highlights the two waypoints. The bad leg is because the distance between the two waypoints are too short. Or you can say you have too many waypoints in your route plan. Okay, let's go to waypoint 6. You can see, oh, I have a lot of waypoints here. So you can either do by moving some of the waypoints here, or as I sometimes do here, I delete when there's too many waypoints. So let's try to delete here. I edit and okay, I will maybe delete this one. Okay. And you see the alarm disappeared. Okay. So actually you just need to either move or delete some waypoints. Okay, this looks a little bit strange here, so I'll just move it a little bit. Don't be worried that some waypoints are not inside the route. You are sailing on the line on the ECDIS here, okay? Yes, then the last one was the bad turn. I don't have a bad turn alarm, but I will see if I can kind of make a bad turn alert for you. Okay, let's try to see if I can do that. Okay, if I increase this one again, let's see. Oh, increase, yes. See, and I try to move this one. Okay, let's see what happens here. Now it's no, it disappeared. But anyways, it's a little bit harder to make the bad turn. The bad turn, it came here, see? Bad turn at waypoint 16. And the bad turn, see, it highlights where the problem issue is. The bad turn is because the calculated rate of turn exceeds the max rate of turn of your ship. So what can you do about that? You can either increase the radius or decrease the speed. Okay, let's see if we can, by increasing, you see, now it becomes an impossible turn instead, so it might not be the best issue here. We could maybe decrease the speed, see if that happens. Anything here? Oh, we have to decrease a lot here to make it happen. Okay, maybe
increase here a little bit. Oh, see, by using the both of them, by oh, now it came back. So you see, this one can be a little bit. Oh, and then it turned into impossible. There it was. Okay, see, so you have to play around a little bit with these alerts. Okay, I hope. Oh, now the alarm came back and became a bad leg. So you have to kind of play around with the waypoints to get the alerts to disappear. Okay, I can maybe see. I can just move the waypoint also, and then it disappeared. So this is how you get rid of these alerts. You have to work a little bit with it and change the parameters of speed, radius, and the position of the waypoint. Okay?
So this was all for the geometry check. I hope you got something out of this instructions here, so you can use in your everyday route planning. Again, thank you for watching our videos, and also thank you for commenting on our videos and asking questions about the different FURUNO equipments. I like to answer you as quickly as I can, if I can, so have a little patience, but thank you very much, okay? So take care of yourself and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.